Figured since we didn't get a full 10-minute video, I'd shoot a little more footage of them running around a plane. Magi right there, Rekkr, Ka-bar. Basically the dominant male making one of the subordinate males behave and not play roughly with the younger members of the pack. He's doing the same thing to Magi there too, again, because the bulldogs have a tendency to play kind of rough because they're bulldogs, and he knows that, so he comes in and he keeps the order. A big wad of spit on your head there, Rekkr. Rekkr, you're playing too rough. Knock it off. Coming over and getting approval from me. Kurgan, I'll pet you in a little bit. He wants to be fed. Alright. Love watching the pack interplay. Absolutely beautiful day. I can't wait to go on today's hike down at the river. I'm gonna take a couple of them with Tammy once she gets home from work. Some of my favorite weather to hike in. Alright, knock it off. I don't want to catch it. My hand's getting cold on his snow-covered fur. handsome. Lobo's the oldest dog here, so he usually just monitors the play from up there. Little kisses. Again, I've got a yard full of unneutered males here. It's possible to have male dogs all living together in a pack situation without any violent fights or any of that. Again, it's when you hinder these natural canine communications between them that you create problems within your pack at home. And that's what causes a lot of fights that escalate. You know, normally in a wolf pack and in a pack, you don't have bloody violent fights. You know, everybody coexists within the rank that is decided within the pack. But don't take my word for it. I'm just some guy on YouTube. I'm just showing you what I do and explaining why I do it as it happens. And you can decide if what I say has some merit or not, as I always say. Bye from Mr. Lobo, Mr. Kurgan, Magi, Rekkr, and the boys. We'll see you.